Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss the point email writing. It is again from unit number 4. So we will discuss this point as email writing. In email writing, here I am going to discuss the 4 points. First one is the introduction, then types of email writing, then email writing format. Fourth point is the key points for email writing. Now, in introduction, email writing. You already know that email is nothing but it stands for the electronic mail. It is the one kind of way, easiest way for the communication purpose where we are going to share the topic or along this email we can attach some sort of the things that may be in document form, that may be any video, that may be any photo, like that we can attach the things. This email writing, email concept, it is having the so many things. We can say that it is the one, that means previously what happened, whatever the matter we want to share, we are writing on a paper, or that means postcard or any other media, and through that we are sending that particular information. But in email writing, what we are doing, we are sharing the information through by the means of the electronic mail, and in that we are, whatever the thing we want to share information, we are writing in a brief. This email writing, that means it should not be that much longer one. It should be in a, you can say that whatever the thing you want to share, it should be in a brief manner, not that much one longer one. And another thing is that this email, sometimes it is very, you can say that useful, and sometimes in the sense many times it is very useful one, but some kind of a thing is that we have to take the care about this particular email writing, because whenever we are sharing this email, might be some history, again it may be sent by us by mistake, or you can see that some personal information can be shared by means of this particular email. So we have to take care about all the things, right? So email writing, nowadays so many people's, family members, friends, business persons, they are using this particular thing for the sharing the information. So this is the all about this particular email writing. Now, email writing, it is again having the 3 kinds of the types. So it is divided in 3 types, you can say that. First is the informal, then second one is the semi-formal email, and third one is the formal email. Now we'll see one by one what is mean by this particular informal mail. So in informal mail, whenever we are writing the that particular topic or that particular message, it is shared with the friends or family members or any relatives, and here some sort of the politeness or polite, we are considering some sort of the use of polite, friendly and casual words we are considering along with that particular, you can see that closing rules and that particular things which is considered in the this email writing. So this is the, you can see that informal writing of the, you can see that email. Now semi-formal email, in semi-formal email what we are considering, we are considering or we are writing this particular mail to our teammates or colleagues, those who are working with us in our office or any other places. And mostly what we are considering, some sort of the friendly language we can use, but maintaining the limit and decency with this particular writing the mail, because we are writing this mail for our colleagues, to our colleagues. We have to remember that. The length, the proper greetings and closing and clarity, these are should be followed in this particular semi-formal email writing concept, right? And third one is the formal email. Now, this formal email writing, it is mostly considered for the business communication purpose or professional use. We can say that in that category, it comes this particular formal email writing. In this formal email writing, we have to consider the some sort of the polite and formal words. We have to consider the clear and proper greeting and closing rules for that particular formal mails. We have to consider, we have to take care about all these things. This kind of a formal writing, it is also considered in government departments, some school authorities, some in many companies and that particular organization, it is considered this particular mail. So these are the three main kinds of the, you can say that types of the email writing, and the format or that particular words are considered, the language it is considered is the same for all these things, but some sort of the you can say that some rules and some you can say that some words, proper words, politeness, polite things we have to consider for this particular writing the email. Now, what is the exact this particular format of this particular email writing? See, even though we have categorized this email in the three parts, but the format for three types, it is the same one. That means this slide shows the particular the format. Where first is the from in the sense who is sending this particular mail. That mail ID you have to write in that particular form. Then reception mail ID, it is considered in the two. And in CC, that means carbon copy, it is said as the carbon copy. In that we have to write the same mail, that individual reception mail ID we can insert, which is visible to all, we can insert in this particular CC. Now, what is mean by this particular BCC? BCC, it is nothing but blank carbon copy, where we can use the individual, or you can say that other individual receiving IDs, okay, but it is not visible to others. It is not visible to others. That we can consider in the particular. Then subject, the title for which reason we are writing the mail, we have to mention in a proper captions. Now, salutation, that like that, dear, respected sir, hi, these things we have to consider in this salutation. Then main body, where we are going to write the exact communication purpose, that topic, that particular you can see that subject related to concept we have to write in this particular main body. It should not be that much lengthier one. Okay, that is the thing. Now closing, that means again ending of this particular main body, that means regards and all that thing we have to consider in this thing. Any attachment with this particular mail, it is considered in an attachment. That may be in the form of the dog, that may be in the form of the, you can see that any other thing, documentary, already I said that, PPTs, photos, all that thing you can attach here. Even though you can consider any video, small video, you can also upload one. And signature line, the sender's name, in that signature line, we have to write the sender's name, is all the details, contact number we have to write. Again, in that particular closing, I forgot one thing I mentioned here. In that closing, after the regard, you have to write some sort of the yours sincerely, yours faithfully, or that particular, if you are sending to the friends, then like that you have to write some sort of the things, so that it will, you can see that, get one good look for that particular thing. Okay. Now, this is all about the whatever the things we have discussed here, but main thing is that key points for the email writing we have to consider one. Here few points I mentioned here for that discussion purpose. See how the email should be there. Okay, and what the things we have to consider, how the things we have to consider in that particular mail here I just given. And I will explain that particular things here. First point is that don't over communicate by the mail. That means the thing which is necessary one, for that reason only write the email. Or if suppose the whatever you want to say, it can be considered by considering the any telephonic call or other things, then it is not necessary to write the mail. And previously I just said that if you have to take care about your mail, whenever you are sending or replying that particular mail which is received by you, okay, and in that if any history it is there, then take care about that particular history. Maybe it is containing some sort of the, you can say that your personal things and all that thing. So you have to consider that thing and you have to then send that particular mail. That means email it is also some sort sometimes creates the problem, because might be unnecessarily your personal things can be shared by the other people. So you have to be concentrated on that particular thing. One more thing is that whenever you are writing the mail, it should not be confuse the receiver, because might be he will get some sort of the tension. Okay, unnecessary tension might be he will take. So to avoid that thing, whatever you are considering that particular topic or that subject, it should be having the, you can see that easy, or you can see that it will be, you can say that minimize the that much stress for the reception. That thing you have to consider one. This is the about the over communicate of that particular mail. Now next point is the make good use of the subject line. Okay, it is also important one. For example, if suppose you are sending a mail to your colleagues those who are working in your office, in that case if suppose you are writing the mail and you are sending that particular mail to the colleagues having the subject as the meeting, so it will not give the details about that particular mail. Instead of that particular meeting, if suppose you are writing that today we are we are going to conduct the meeting for that particular results of the past results at 3 o'clock, if suppose like that you are mentioning in a subject line, then it will clearly clarify that your main motto of this particular mail. Like our newspaper, see in newspaper whatever the topic is there, on that topic the heading is important, they are giving the good heading, right? And by reading that heading we will get that idea, oh it is how it is important that particular topic. Like that you have to consider this the subject line. Remember this one. Now next one is the keep messages clear and brief. This is the third key point. Keep messages clear and brief. Whenever you are considering the body of that particular communication part, right? Before that you are writing the salutation, that means dear sir, dear ma'am, or hi friends, like that, dear friends, like that you are considering one. After that, whatever the communication body you are considering one, whatever the topic, whatever the subject you are considering one, that should be mentioned in a clearly one, which is not having that much lengthier one. You can consider two more paragraphs to clarify that particular thing, but not more than two one, because that particular body it should not be that much lengthy one, because reader should understand what you want to say here, and that particular message should be a brief one. That much lengthy message should not be there, which can be understand by the receiver. And simple and grammatically good language, English language, it should be used one in that particular email, while writing that particular email and considering that message body, right? You have to consider this one. Now it is the important thing. Fourth one is the be polite in that thing. Whenever you are finishing your main body, communication body, and you are end, you want to end that particular, you can say that email, at that time after the finishing you have to write regards or yours sincerely. These things you have to use one. Directly don't close the your mail. Remember this thing. It will, you can see that look, it will improve, or you can see that impression of that email will be improved one. That is the thing. Now, check your tone. It is also important one. In that particular message, you have to write good message. That means you have to, that means your communication body should be in a proper manner. Even though you are writing, you are supposed to get that information from your colleagues, but in that you have to write the proper communication language. For example, hi, hi friends, or hi my dear friend. Today I am having the one important meeting, and for that, as usual, I discuss with you. You just share that information which is required to me to complete for that particular meeting. Okay, like that you have to, some sort of the things you have to consider one. Instead of why you are not sending that particular message because I am going to attend the meeting. It is the again. It is again. We can say that unnecessarily it will. What the thing we can say that unnecessarily it will creates the bad message in a reception, right? So your tone should be in a good manner, even though you are asking some sort of the things from the your friends or your colleagues. Okay, that is the thing. And last one is the proofread. It is also main important thing, because before clicking on the send button, you have to read the entire mail from starting the 2.2 from that particular 2 subject line, then salutation, message body, again whatever the closing that particular your sincerely and all that thing, then your signature, all that thing you have to take care about. You have to check in that particular message body whether unnecessarily I am not written anything which will harm that particular reception, receiver person. Unnecessarily my image will be, you can see that impression will be decreased, that means bad impression will be created in that particular reception. That thing you have to take care about this thing. Whatever the tone I used in that particular language, it should be in a proper, simple English language. You can say that in a good, politely, you have to write the mail. That thing it is written in a proper way or not, that you have to check one. And then only you have to click on the send button. Right? So this thing, these key points you have to remember one while writing the mail. Okay, got the thing? All right, this is the all about the key points. Now I will show some sort of the, I will discuss or whatever the we discuss that particular informal, semi-formal and you can say that formal mail. I will say share with you some example sample mail so that you will get the idea. See, this is, this slide shows the one sample informal email which is considered for your friends. Okay, and you are inviting for the birthday party. See here how the that thing it is written. So in that two it is considered the mail ID, then subject and invitation to a birthday party. Okay, instead of writing the invitation, it is written in a full one, invitation to birthday party. That particular salutation, hi, then the main body, and the last is the that particular ending of that particular, and your see you soon, LMN, that means you are closing that particular mail. It is closed with that particular mail with having the good, you can see that remarks or signature. Right, this is the sample one for the informal mail. Now for this sample for the semi-formal, in this again it is considered for the your classmates regarding the intra-college quiz competition. See in subject line what it is written, intra-college quiz competition. Instead of the only computation. That subject it is considered a full meaning. Okay, so that receiver can read it carefully, right? That is the thing. So here, hello everyone, and that particular brief message it is considered, and after that thanks and whatever the signature, in this your class representative, that thing it is considered one, right? Okay, this is the sample one for the semi formal, and last one is the for formal. See how it is considered. One of the person, he want to give the resignation in company. So what he written? Entire in subject, resignation letter, and that particular person, that means considering the salutation as a dear sir. In that particular message board, he is mentioned the entire thing related to that particular point, and in the that particular ending of that particular mail, he is written as the thanks and regards, and after that he is written his signature as the LMN project head, right? So this is all about the, you can say that that means sample mail for the formal, semi formal and informal things. So this is whatever I want to share with you regarding the email writing. Email writing is nothing but one kind of a writing a letter to the maybe friends, maybe your family, maybe your relatives, maybe in your classmates or colleagues, or maybe in a office or business related, that particular thing is there. So every format, that particular mail, it is the same for all the, you can see that types, only the matter it gets changed, because this mail, it can be considered for the this mail writing, it is can be considered for the application purpose, for the quotation purpose, in a business consideration, in many government offices also they are using this particular mail writing for the sharing the information. So remember that thing, the format may be it is same, but the that communication language, it may be changed according to that particular use of the concept, type of that particular writing the mail. So if students, if you are having any doubt related to the this particular mail, you can again share that particular doubt with me. Thank you once again.